फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई लाइक टू कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर सिक्योरिंग वेरी गुड स्कोर्स एंड ग्रेट रैंक्स. सो जस्ट हैव अ गुड राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर योर सेल्फ सो दैट यू चेयर अप. गुड राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर योर सेल्फ. And then I would like to thank Gate Academy team and the faculty members of the Gate Academy for their selfless efforts they put in to just have these kind of initiatives, which I think probably there's nowhere else all these things happen just for you. Okay, so a big thank to Gate Academy team and especially Umesh Dhande sir, because due to him, most of people over here are taking teaching as their inspiration and profession. So a big round of applause for Dhande sir too. So I'll tell my journey. I won't go into why NITI, why not IITs, why not PSUs. So I'll tell my story, my journey, so that you can introspect and probably make better decision, because I consider you all are mature enough to take your own decisions. We are just here to guide you. So I am Karthike Pandey. My AIR was 275 from electrical engineering. I converted IIT Kanpur, Kharagpur and Delhi, Delhi. And then I converted Power Grid, and I was also selected in NITI Mumbai. And at the end, I chose NITI Mumbai due to various factors, which probably I can answer in QA sessions. And then so let's take NITI as a system. I'll tell you the input, the process over there, the external factors, internal factors, the feedback, and the output which you get from NITI. So coming into NITI, there's a comprehensive process in NITI, that is, you'll have your GDs. They'll first shortlist based on your GATE score. There are lot of misconceptions regarding NITI, regarding the branches you are in, regarding the inputs you are required to, regarding the preparation you need to have. So just put all the misconceptions aside. So they'll call you according to your GATE score rather than your branch or anything else. So you'll be shortlisted for your GDs and PIs. So they have kind of some weightage for GD, some weightage for PI. Rajat told many things about NITI, the interview experience and the GD experience. So I won't go into much detail of that, because you all know. So basically, you need to perform good in GD. You should not be very conversant in your English, but you should have confidence in yourself. And then regarding PI, they'll mostly ask you questions related to your HR and your major project. So once you are in NITI, then the real process starts. As you know, now most of the PSUs are actually trusting NITI. They send their management trainees to NITI for getting their managerial skills to a higher level. So life at NITI is pretty nice. The campus, as it's known as God's own campus, it is surrounded by three lakes. And there is one personal pond in our campus to chill around. And then regarding the academics and curriculum, it has technical tinge to it, but it is also management driven. So basically, the designation which we get after placements are majority is managerial positions. And in technical aspect, yes, as Rajat told you, that it is towards the operational research side, but it's not totally true in true sense. NITI is very much updated to the present world scenario. So you will be learning a lot of softwares, and you will be learning new things which will be really useful once you proceed in your life. And regarding the curriculum, it's not that heavy as the M.Tech thing. So they offer three programs, that is PGD-IE, PGD-MM, that is Manufacturing Management, and PGD-PM, that is Project Management. So the entry for all three courses are through GATE only. So you don't need to worry about which course is better, which is not. All are equivalent in terms of placements, because there is a common placement for all of the three batches. And in NITI, there is 50% ratio of work ex people and freshers. So that's a big, big thing, because in my class, there are people who are coming from IOCL, NTPC, ONGC, and also from big MNCs which you have heard of. So basically, that's a upgradation of your whatever school skills you possess. So in NITI, they don't emphasize more on learn these things, or they'll leave you on your own so that you have a open environment, so that you can have exposure and you can learn a lot of things over there. And regarding with the, I told you about in terms of technology, and it is very much updated regarding technology. And now I'll talk about the output which you get from Nitti. So I'll talk personal output and professional output. In terms of professional output, I don't think any of the colleges which are offering M.Tech offer packages as Nitti does. Because average package in Nitti is at around 16 to 17 lakhs and the median package is 15 to 16. So it's a very decent package to start with. And there is nothing as such a line between the WorkX people and freshers. We all get equal opportunity in terms of companies. And the companies you see in TVs and all, they actually visit us. We have around 100 to 120 companies visiting us. And as this is government college, there is 100% placement for all of you. And the minimum package is around 10 lakhs. So you can just imagine the kind of how big the Nitti is. And the biggest thing, the biggest disadvantage in terms of Nitti is most of you don't have information regarding Nitti. So as Gate Academy invited me as an ambassador of Nitti, so it's my right to tell you that Nitti is a very big college. So don't hear of misconceptions. There are very less amount of relevant information regarding Nitti, which you all should know. Because in terms of professional thing, you'll be most probably working in MNC, which you have seen in TVs and all. Then you have packages at around 16, 17 lakhs. What else do you want in your life? And regarding the personal thing, so you'll have hell lot of exposure in terms of global exposures. We have exchange program in Germany, England, and other countries as well. Then there are companies which actually give you posting in countries like South Korea, in UK, in Germany, and other countries as well. So you won't be, you'll get enough opportunities to explore yourself. And then in terms of your personal growth, you'll have your confidence level rising all over your career. And then if you'll start with company which is actually providing you the opportunity, which is actually providing the platform so that you can explore yourself. So what else do you want in your life? And the last thing which I want to say is, if you have any question, we'll probably take in the QA sessions. I know you all have many doubts regarding the Nitti and all. And so I'll probably clear that out. So what I'll say is, you all should have some purpose. And with that purpose comes motivation. And once you get that motivation, you'll ultimately put the hard work which is required for your success. So in whatever field you are getting into, whether it is IIT or PSU or for that matter Nitti or in teaching, you should have that purpose in your life so that you are motivated enough to put on the hard work. So with this, I'll end my lecture or whatever the thing is. So I hope you all are very much enlightened regarding Nitti. So don't have misconceptions. Gather information regarding Nitti. If you didn't apply this time, for probably next time or after 1 or 2 years of experience, you can always apply. So best of luck for your future endeavors. And thank you for this opportunity. Thank you, Gate Academy.